picture this. You're holding your smartphone right now, and inside it are dozens of tiny magnets working silently to make everything function. From the speaker that delivers crystal clear sound to the vibration motor that buzzes when you get a text message. But have you ever wondered how these incredible pieces of technology actually come to life? Today we're diving deep into one of the most fascinating manufacturing processes on Earth. And trust me, by the end of this video, you'll never look at magnets the same way again. The global magnet industry is absolutely massive, worth over $40 billion and growing at breakneck speed. Why? Because magnets are literally everywhere in our modern world. They're powering electric vehicles, generating clean energy in wind turbines, and even helping doctors save lives in MRI machines. But here's what blew my mind when I first learned about this. The journey from raw earth elements to the powerful magnets in your devices involves some of the most extreme temperatures and precise engineering you can imagine. Let me take you back thousands of years to where this incredible story begins. Ancient Greek shepherds were among the first to discover something truly magical. Around 600 BCE, they noticed that certain black rocks in the region of Magnesia could mysteriously attract their iron tools. They called this strange mineral magnetite, and little did they know, they had just stumbled upon a force that would revolutionize human civilization. But the Greeks weren't the only ones fascinated by these mysterious rocks. On the other side of the world, Chinese inventors were having their own breakthrough moment. They figured out how to use magnetite's magical properties for something that would change navigation forever, the compass. By the first century CE, Chinese sailors were using magnetic needles to find their way across vast oceans, giving them a massive advantage in exploration and trade. As knowledge of magnetism spread across Europe during the Middle Ages, it captured the imagination of scholars and inventors. Then came a pivotal moment in the 16th century when William Gilbert, physician to Queen Elizabeth I, made an earth-shattering discovery. He proposed something that seemed impossible at the time. Our entire planet is actually one giant magnet. His scientific documentation of magnetism laid the groundwork for everything that would follow. The 19th century brought revolutionary breakthroughs that would reshape our understanding of the universe itself. Scientists like Michael Faraday and James Clerk Maxwell discovered the incredible relationship between electricity and magnetism. These weren't just academic discoveries. They were the foundation for electric generators, motors, and virtually every piece of electronic technology we use today. Now here's where things get really interesting. Modern magnet manufacturing is like watching science fiction become reality. Let's journey to China, where most of the world's magnets are produced, and step inside one of these incredible factories. The process begins with what might seem like mundane raw materials, but choosing the right ingredients is absolutely critical. For the most powerful magnets, called neodymium magnets, manufacturers need three key elements: neodymium, iron, and boron. Neodymium is a rare earth metal that's incredibly reactive and expensive, so every gram must be handled with extreme care. The iron provides structural strength, while boron acts like a molecular stabilizer, helping the magnet maintain its power even under harsh conditions. But here's where the magic really starts. These materials are weighed with pharmaceutical precision and combined in exact ratios. Even tiny variations can dramatically affect the final magnet's performance. For ferrite magnets, which are more common but less powerful, the recipe includes iron oxides mixed with barium or strontium carbonates. Next comes one of the most spectacular parts of the entire process, the melting phase. Imagine temperatures reaching 1500 degrees Celsius as these materials are liquefied in massive induction furnaces. But here's the twist that makes neodymium magnets so special. Instead of slow cooling, the molten metal is poured onto a rapidly spinning cold surface. This creates almost instant solidification, forming incredibly thin sheets and preventing large crystal formation that could weaken the magnet. Ferrite magnets follow a completely different path. The mixture is heated to over 1000 degrees Celsius, where a chemical transformation occurs. The ingredients literally combine at the molecular level to create new compounds with magnetic properties. This heated powder then goes through sintering, where individual grains fuse together under intense heat and pressure. The next stage is where precision engineering meets brute force. The cooled materials are ground in specialized ball mills using steel or ceramic spheres that pulverize everything into incredibly fine powder. This isn't just crushing, it's creating uniform particle sizes measured in micrometers. The finer the powder, the better the alignment during the next crucial step. This powder is then placed into molds while being subjected to powerful magnetic fields. Think of it like billions of tiny compass needles, all being forced to point in the same direction simultaneously. This alignment is absolutely essential because it determines how strong the final magnet will be. Poor alignment means a weak magnet. Perfect alignment means maximum magnetic force. But we're still not done with the extreme temperatures. The compacted material goes back into furnaces reaching up to 1,000 degrees Celsius for neodymium magnets, or even 1,200 degrees for ferrite magnets. This sintering process partially melts the particles, eliminating air gaps and creating incredibly dense, solid pieces. The gradual cooling that follows is just as important as the heating, preventing internal stresses that could crack the magnet. Now comes the precision machining phase, where these incredibly hard blocks are cut into exact shapes using diamond tools or laser technology. We're talking about cutting some of the hardest materials on Earth with tolerances measured in fractions of millimeters. Any error here could ruin months of work and thousands of dollars in materials. Here's something that might surprise you. At this point, we have pieces that could become magnets, but they're not actually magnetic yet. That requires one final, spectacular step. The sintered blocks are placed inside massive copper coils that generate magnetic fields so powerful they could literally pull the iron out of your blood. When these fields are applied, the internal magnetic domains that were previously chaotic suddenly snap into perfect alignment, creating a permanent magnet. For neodymium magnets, there's one more crucial step that most people never think about: protection. These incredibly powerful magnets are also incredibly vulnerable to corrosion. Without proper coating, exposure to moisture and air will cause them to deteriorate rapidly. That's why they're coated with materials like nickel, zinc, or epoxy resins. These protective layers not only prevent corrosion, but also give the magnets their characteristic shiny appearance. The final stage involves rigorous quality testing that would make a laboratory jealous. Magnetic strength is measured with precision instruments, pole orientation is verified, and resistance to temperature and corrosion is thoroughly tested. Only magnets that pass these demanding standards make it to market. The packaging process is an art form in itself. These powerful magnets could attract each other with enough force to cause serious injury, so they're carefully separated with non-magnetic materials and packed in specially designed containers that protect them during shipping. What amazes me most about this entire process is how it transforms simple earth elements into objects that can lift thousands of times their own weight, generate electricity, or create the precise movements needed in life-saving medical equipment. From ancient Greek shepherds picking up iron tools with mysterious rocks, to factories producing magnets that power our digital world, this journey represents thousands of years of human curiosity and innovation. The next time you use your smartphone, start your car, or flip a light switch, remember that you're benefiting from one of the most incredible manufacturing processes ever developed. These tiny but mighty magnets are literally holding our modern world together, one perfectly aligned magnetic domain at a time. What did you think about this incredible journey from raw materials to finished magnets? Did any part of the process surprise you? Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed discovering the secrets behind magnet manufacturing, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more fascinating deep dives into the technology that shapes our world.